Hello everyone, today we will discuss the various diseases related to the heart. Now first of all we have angina pectoris. In this the coronary arteries actually get narrowed, so the blood supply to the heart muscle actually decreases, and so the heart is also not able to pump enough amount of blood to the various body parts. Over here as you can see the diagram, this is the normal artery and this is the angina pectoris artery. In the angina pectoris, remember that the artery doesn't get blocked completely. In the myocardial infarction, actually the blockage of the heart is complete, but in the angina pectoris there is partial blockage of the arteries. So means the arteries get narrowed, not completely blocked. Over here there is the patient actually feels pain while exertion for about 20 minutes, and the pain increases on exertion and decreases at rest, as because the arteries get so much narrow that ischemia occurs only during exertion. What is ischemia? Ischemia, that means a restricted blood flow to the particular organ. Now the referred pain over here is at the left shoulder, medial arm and the forearm. So just remember, in angina pectoris there is narrowing of the coronary artery or the arteries of the heart. Now the next is the myocardial infarction. Over here, as you can see in the diagram, there is complete blockage of the arteries of the heart, as you can see. This may be because of the plaque deposited and occluding the coronary artery, or we can say kind of cholesterol particles. Now here there is sudden block of the coronary artery, which actually leads to the ischemia and then infarction. Ischemia is the restrictive flow of the blood, and the infarction is the blockage of the blood flow. Now the part of the heart which is suffering from the myocardial infarction has low blood supply, of course. So because the heart doesn't get enough supply, so death of the person occurs due to the heart attack. Now over here the clinical features of the MI are pain and pressure in the chest for about 30 minutes, nausea, vomiting, breathlessness, and tachycardia occurs. Why tachycardia over here? Because the heart only is not getting enough blood. So how it will be able to pump enough amount of blood to the whole body? So it pumps so fastly that tachycardia occurs. Now the referred pain, which mainly occurs in the arm, shoulders, neck and jaw. So in short, angina pectoris means partial blockage or narrowing of the arteries of the heart, and the myocardial infarction means the complete blockage of the heart by the plaque or cholesterol particles, and so the muscles of the heart get damaged and the person dies because of the heart attack. Now what are the site of occlusion of the coronary artery? Now we have many coronary artery and its branches. Out of them, mainly the artery which is maximum blockage rate is the left anterior interventricular artery, branch of left coronary artery, about 40-50% risk. Right coronary artery risk is about 30-40%, and the circumflex artery, again a branch of left coronary artery, has a around risk of 50-20%, but the maximum rate is the for the left anterior interventricular artery, branch of left coronary artery. Now the coronary angiography. As you can see, this is the photo, or the we can say the x-ray of the coronary angiography. In this is a process actually that actually uses contrast dye, usually containing the iodine, and the x-ray pictures to detect the blockages in the coronary artery that are mainly caused by the plaque buildup or the cholesterol in it. So in short, it is mainly used to detect the position of the blockage of the heart. Now next is the coronary bypass surgery. Now this surgery is mainly done when there is severe obstruction of the coronary artery. As you can see over here in this figure, the coronary artery is completely blocked. Okay, so just in order to make the blood flow normal, what they will do is they will do a bypass surgery. In this, one segment of any vein or artery is connected to the ascending aorta, or we can say to the proximal part of the obstructed coronary artery. As you can see, this part is obstructed. So proximal to this part, that means over here, they will connect one segment of artery or vein, or at the ascending aorta, and the other end of the vein or the artery is connected to the distal part of the coronary artery, somewhere over here. So the blood will shunt from the particular part, that means the ascending aorta, and it will come into the coronary arteries distal part. So blood shunts from the ascending aorta to the coronary arteries distal part. So this blocked part will not be in use further. Mainly for this bypass surgery or the shunting process, great saphenous vein is used. Why? Because this vein is actually valveless and almost of the same diameter as that of the vessels of the heart. Another vein or artery that is used in this process is the left internal mammary artery, which is not much used, but the greatly used vein is the great saphenous vein, which is maximum used in the coronary bypass surgery process. So, in short, the coronary bypass surgery is mainly done when the heart vessels or the coronary artery is completely blocked. But in another case, that means in the coronary angioplasty, it is mainly done when the heart vessels get narrowed, or we can say it is mainly done when there is angina pectoris or the narrowing of the coronary artery. In this, a small catheter with small inflatable balloon is attached to the tips of the blocked part of the coronary artery, and then the balloon is inflated. So what will happen, whatever the plaque will be there occluding the artery will get flattened towards the lumen, and this will increase the lumen of the coronary artery. So this is another option then of the bypass surgery. That means just inflate the balloon, and whatever the lumen is blocked, it will flatten and will increase the lumen of the coronary artery, and the blood will flow again back normally. So, in order to make the normal blood flow to the heart, we have mainly two options. That is the coronary bypass surgery, in which we have to do the surgery connecting the veins or the artery from the ascending aorta to the distal part of the blocked part of the coronary artery, or the coronary angioplasty, where a small catheter with small inflatable balloon is attached to the tip of the blocked part of the coronary artery and it is inflated, so the lumen actually get back to its normal size. So, this was all about the disease related to the heart. Hope you understood it well. Thank you so much.